have Pioneer amplifier, and it's going into protection mode. So it probably has some sort of short. Okay, could have been right now. So here's the inside of the machine, and I can immediately see that there is two blown fuses right down in there. So those fuses are gone. So that means that there's a short. Most definitely, probably a short somewhere on this board. Place to look for the shorts are these transistors right here, these sound amplifying transistors, and collector emitter beast. Just make sure that there's no short on these guys here. This guy down in here, he has a short.
It's a dead short on this guy. The other ones seem to be okay. So these two header guys
seem to be bad, so we'll have to take this system apart to get down in there. So it is the D2390 and the B1560 that have gone bad. Again, just put it in continuity mode, and you shouldn't get a short on any of those pins. It should be like at least half a volt. So we'll remove. Interesting, they have copper screws. Never seen copper screws. That's interesting.
Okay.
I have a solder sucker. Don't even need a solder sucker. Just peel. There we go. I'm just going to test them out again. See if they beep.
Yeah. And
they were both shorted. So both these guys in that order, so be N channel and P channel, I'm guessing. So I'll see if I can order those. Maybe I have them in stock. That's data sheet. So we have a D2390 data sheet, and we want to just check out what that is. So that's the MPN. It's an audio device here. And you want to see the voltage and the current. Those are the... the two things that we have to make sure. So, like, we want around 10 amps. And then the other one is the B1560 data sheet, and that will be the opposite. So that's a PMP, 150 volts, 10 amp. So let's see if you can find them on DigiKey. I do have some here.
10 amp fuses.
Alright, here goes nothing. I'm gonna turn on. So I turn it off. I'm gonna check those fuses. Okay, they're good. So we'll feed some music into them here. Something's hot. So here I have this little board that goes before the amp, and it seems that this branch here, just that 2 MOSFET, is shorting out. And I believe that this is for switching on that transistor. And then on here, we have a little transistor here, and these are all parallel. They're like the same circuit format, and I should get 0.6 on this. On this one I also will get 0.6. So this one we got 0.6. But on this one, it's almost a short, so therefore it's always setting that high. So I have to replace this little IC right here. So this machine had a couple things that were wrong. Still going in protection mode, but these two transistors were shorted. So this is NMP, and when that's shorted, these two resistors around, they're kind of blowing up. And the other thing I found was there's this little transistor, and if this is an N-channel transistor, if that is gone, it automatically blows out those resistors. So I replaced that. I put an N-channel MOSFET on it, and you can kind of swap them, but if you don't have that installed, it will blow again. So after replacing all that stuff, still goes into protection mode. I'm not 100% sure. I'm not 100% sure why. It could be because I use not exactly the right components, but I got it from other AVR system and I popped it in here. So it just troubles. It's always showing this symbol here, NG. So that's basically there. It detected an issue with the amplifier units. It'll turn off. So the repair on this is not looking too good. I also found some MOSFETs that were bad on the bottom of the board and replaced these guys, and had another transistor on this board. That's just showing that it's a cascading effect, so one problem's causing a whole bunch. I've replaced that and it's still not working. I don't have the schematic for this, so I'm thinking that that's it. I'm just going to leave this because there's a point between the time you spend on something and its repairability. For this one, if you know exactly what's wrong, you can put a comment in the description, but it'll help out the majority of people. Is check these. These ones usually go with the amp, and then also check this board, that transistor, because otherwise when you replace these, it'll blow again. And we also have those 2-watt 0.22 ohm resistors, and they will blow in series with those if this board's not fixed. So yeah, I replaced the fuses and all that stuff. So okay, hope this helped someone.
Thanks for watching this video. Hope it helped out. If you enjoy electronics or want to learn about how to fix electronics, consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.